What's going on, folks? Yo, 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 what's up? What is going on? The tunes are pumping. Sarah, Elizabeth, Tracy Ann. How you doing, folks? It's all happening. Another day in the apocalypse. It's been a while. Elizabeth Morris, how are you doing? Sophie Senza, Renee Greger, Heather. Please let us know where you are tuning in from, folks. Tunes are on. It's been wild. Hey, Nikki. Howdy, howdy, howdy. Trying to work with the lighting in here. Let a few people tune in. Hey, Rob. Yes, Joe. It has been a long time. Joe Avercios, is it? Michael Archangel, howdy, howdy. Please let us know where you're tuning in from. We're just going to let a couple of people tune in. It's been a little while since I jumped on for an episode of the Zombie Apocalypse. Hope you're all well. It is an asylum. Australia has truly become the laughingstock and the horror show of the world. The world is completely baffled and astonished at what is actually happening here in this country. But we live to fight another day, folks. We'll let a few more people tune in. Please leave a comment. Let us know where you are tuning in from. It is a big wide world out there, and we are all living through this absolute insanity together. If you're not already on the Telegram chat, the Dave Oneegs Aussie chat, we are on our way to 42,500 subscribers there on the chat. It's one of the arguably the best chat group in Australia. There's so much good information there. So please, I hope you're on Telegram. Facebook is dead. All the good people have been censored. That's the problem with Facebook, folks. I'll let a couple more people tune in. Close a couple of windows here. Hey, the tunes. Kim Hamilton from the Hunter Valley. Ginny Tilcock, Adrian, howdy, howdy, thanks for tuning in. Muya Kenny, Helen Cotter, howdy, howdy. She got a text from the government telling her to get her jab. Donna Batten, Northern Ireland. Hey, Donna, all the way from Northern Ireland. That is phenomenal. Well, thanks for tuning in. I feel very special. Demsmar, Jacqueline. No, we are not the laughing stock. They're upset for us. You're right. It's true. They're very upset. Here we go. Good tunes, folks. Good tunes. Good tunes. Well, good evening, folks. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's been a while. Welcome to a long overdue episode of the Zombie Apocalypse. Took a few weeks off doing lives here on Facebook for a number of reasons. One of the big ones is, you know, when you really stick your head out there in social media, sometimes you just need to have a break. The other one is I'm starting to see the other, how can I say, see the other plans and the other agendas that are actually behind the current agenda that we are all waking up to, right? The whole great awakening that we're seeing. You know, many people who would follow my content and who, you know, I guess would describe themselves, broadly speaking, as truthers or as people who have taken the red pill. Please smash up the likes if you say you're someone, if you believe you're someone who's taken the red pill. Well, I've started to see some other interesting information that the red pill is not what it's all cracked up to be, but the red pill is just another stepping stone and yet another, how can I say, another deception that is leading this mass awakening into yet Another trap. So sorry to bust anyone's bubble. Just being real with you all, which you guys know I love to do. That's what I really, you know, that's what's important to me is cutting through, excuse me, cutting through to the truth of the matter. And the truth is that everything that we're seeing play out in front of us right now is a movie. It is, it's all planned. And the people orchestrating it are so far ahead and so far advanced in terms of their planning and the way they socially engineer society and psychologically manipulate the collective psyche of the masses that it is very difficult to stay abreast of what they're actually doing and be able to see the larger plan unfold. But I can assure you right now, one of the reasons I haven't been as vocal here on Facebook and going live as often is because I'm starting to put new pieces to the puzzle together. And some of that information is really quite challenging. You know, I think one of the one things that we have to be very, very cognizant of as people who are, I guess, truth seekers is that we have to be able to constantly re-examine our position and constantly be able to doubt our own beliefs. Because let's face it, the more you learn, the less you know. You just start to realize this is so big and so vast and everything we were ever told has been a lie. And then you'll find out that everything that we think is true turns out to be another level of deception all again. And I actually found myself looking at some of the things that I've been, I guess, promoting or speaking about or endorsing and starting to realize, you know what? No one, especially myself, no one is immune from deception and no one is immune to psychological manipulation on some level, even if it's very, very subtle. And even if there's a master plan unfolding, we may not necessarily see the traps that are set for us. And I know we think we're awake and guilty as charged. We call the people with the muzzles on the zombies. And, you know, there can be an element of, you know, we're awake and you're not can creep into it. Happens to all of us. We're all human, right? We've all got egos and so on. And we can see, we believe we can see the agenda unfolding, but we can't always necessarily see it. And the moment we think we've worked it out, the moment we think we understand what's actually going on, we're being played again, folks. Think about that. The moment that we think we've got it worked out, that's when you can be pretty sure you have fallen into yet another level of being deceived, because we don't know what's going on. I believe the only person who really knows what's going on is God. So you turn to God. If God guides your life, you're going to be okay. Because we don't have the actual ability, cognitive ability, to fathom the scale of the plan that's unfolding. And there's also another part of me, folks, that, you know, I was jumping up and down and screaming down the screen 18 months ago for Australians to wake up, you know, and Australians to wake up and stand up to this tyranny and to this, I guess, this new system that's being pushed on us, right? It's calling for Aussie men to wake up and open their eyes, to speak up and stand up and you know, fight for our freedoms and so on. And I still know that these are important things to do. If freedom is something that is earned, it's and something that's easily taken away. But I'm personally coming to another understanding that there is a lot of things that just have to play out, folks. They just have to run their course. We're seeing, and I know many of you are, you know, very aware that we are seeing biblical prophecy unfold by the day, literally by the day. And there's a lot of warnings there in the Bible. And if you're not familiarizing yourself with the Bible, you know, with an open mind and, you know, spending some time there and even watching videos that help you understand it a bit better. If you're not doing that, you're definitely missing out, because there is just so many treasures of wisdom in there and so much guidance. It's basically a matrix escape guide as far as I can see. And so, you know, I've just sort of pulled my head in a little bit, which is a good thing to do. Like, I sort of, you know, realize that, of course, I don't know all the answers, and I've started to really question what's going on. And it's been a very, very interesting couple of weeks with politics here in Australia, seeing Gladys Berejiklian step down and this new fellow, Dominic Perrottet, step in. Quite extraordinary to see that. But I just wanted to give you all a quick update what's actually happening over there in ICU. Just a quick update. We've got some people here in ICU. The Channel 9 have been investigating.
Dizzy and her heart rate's too high and she's finding it hard to breathe.
This is Farwaz, the tradie from Putney.
So please get vaccinated. I wish I'd go beforehand.
Ramona is a single mum of two kids.
They're
she
back.
Works in a pharmacy in Greenacre. A few days short of her second dose, she caught the virus.
This is real and this is for, you know, Australia. The whole...
Can you believe, can you believe they still left this up? It's still online. They got completely caught out. They got completely caught out with crisis actors, but they're so sloppy with their propaganda, they've left it up. We're just going to do a quick little health check on Osama. Where's Osama? Hold on. Let's check on Osama, folks. Make sure he's hanging in there. Straight to the ICU ward.
35-year-old tradie Osama from Lakemba. His wife has also been in ICU with COVID.
Can you remember how sick you felt at the worst of it?
It was close to death. It was pretty...
He's trying to stop. There is so much comedy gold in this. It's still there. This is someone, a poorly paid crisis actor, doing his best not to crack up. Here he goes. Oh! Let's see if we can get that little screen grab on Osama.
How sick you felt.
How sick did you feel, Osama?
It was close to death. It was pretty...
It was pretty bad. Close to death. Oh, I love this fella. It just cheers me up every time, folks. You know what? I found some more... I found another one just earlier. This was July 14th, just gone by a couple of months back. This was the first look inside Sydney's COVID-19 ICU ward. Now, are they making fun of this fella? I'm really sorry, but are they making fun of this fella? I'm not fat shaming him, but this person is clearly not in the peak of physical health, right? I'm guessing if this unfortunate gentleman here, and I'm actually guessing he's a legitimate hospital patient. I don't know. But he is morbidly obese. This man is clearly a ticking time bomb, right? He would be absolute ticking time bomb for a heart attack. But this is the sort of stuff they're putting out. Let's have a listen. I haven't listened to this one, by the way. Let's watch it together.
The rhythmic, laboured breath of a COVID patient on oxygen. A machine is helping him breathe. This footage taken yesterday inside the ICU ward at St Vincent's Hospital, known as the Red Zone, exclusive to COVID cases. Every patient has their own dedicated team. Nurses in full PPE to stop cross-infection. There's no downtime, continuously monitoring and assessing vital signs to ensure their patient doesn't deteriorate. Sydney Morning Herald photographer Kate Geraghty was given special...
Sorry, but look at this. That is just... Yeah. Photographer, right? Doctored lighting, the whole, all done for effect. It's just getting so old, folks. That's the thing. It's getting so old. And we had this, look at this one, this new Premier Dominic Perrottet, the major New South Wales roadmap to freedom changes revealed. I found this interesting. I just checked on this before we jumped on the live. Look at that. Look who's there. Did you see that?
And the glass is now more than a half full. Sorry. From one Prime Minister to another.
Hold there.
We have passed
Let's
the
go back on
major
that.
Milestone.
Watch this. Look who's
on
here.
The wall and the glass.
So this is quite incredible. I'm just going to blow this up, right? You've got old Bob Hawke there. Every jab gets us closer to the pub. This is how this is how they appeal to Australians. They're basically saying, take an untested, unsafe, unknown, unnecessary medical experiment. Take it and you'll get beer. All endorsed by this creep. This creep who's complicit in the selling out of Australia, whose own daughter was raped by a colleague of his and he covered it up. These are facts. All there on the public record. This is how sick this country is, folks. You then have this creep who would not even go into bat for his own daughter who was sexually assaulted, right? Now, on brickwork, encouraging you to get injected with experiments so you can go to the pub. This country, and this is probably why, this is what I was alluding to earlier, folks. This country is not going to be saved. And a lot of people don't want to hear that. They want to hear that we're going to win and we're going to take our country back and that it's all going to be happy kumbayas all the way into the sunset with unicorns and rainbows and kangaroos and platypuses and dolphins jumping out of the water in celebration and Skippy the kangaroo and the whole fucking box and dice. None of that's happening, folks. This country, and I'm really sorry to say, it's fucking rotten. To the core, it is fucking rotten. And I know there's good people out there. I know there's good people out there. There's plenty. But sadly, they are a minority. And these are harsh things to say, folks. But when you've got this sort of stuff going on, and you've still got, after almost 2 years, you have millions, hundreds of thousands of families actually now willing to drop their children off to pharmacies, to vaccination hubs and so on, to get the Moderna injection, right? Moderna have never made an injection in the history of their entire country. Sorry, the history of their entire company. They have never made an injection before. So you have people who have no ability to use common sense, no ability to see through this agenda. And I'm sorry, if you can't see through this, you are completely cut off from your creator, from your spirit, from your soul. And if you're cut off from your soul and if you're cut off from your God, it's not going to end well for anyone. And that's where the festering, rotten crap starts to sink into a country. And that's what we've got. That's why you've got hundreds of thousands of people willing to roll this thing out every single day, unquestioned. Hundreds of thousands of them. They are willing to push this crap. They're willing to set up the COVID testing. They're willing to push the poison injection into children, into the elderly, into anyone. They're willing to run the aged care facilities where they treat our elderly like dogs, locked up in darkness, dehydrated, fucking malnourished. You've got an entire police force that after 21 months, they're all still silent. The absolute disgusting police brutality that we've seen down there. We've had, what, 3 or 4 maximum come out and make a bit of noise public? 3 or 4 out of an estimated 70,000 police officers in this country have had something to say that this isn't on? A handful have come out. I'm sure there's plenty more out there. But at this stage, you can only look at the character of Australia and the shit that people are rolling out and say, sorry, this country's, it's not what we thought it was, folks. And I think that's where the real disappointment comes in. Have a listen.
Glass is now more than a half full. From one Prime Minister to another.
We have passed the first major milestone for Australians to start getting their lives back.
The 70% target had the new Premier rolling out his own version of the COVID roadmap, assembling his new look A-team
but with a key player missing.
Well, it is a health crisis, so the Chief Health Officer should be here. Yes.
These are sensible changes, worked through with Dr. Chan.
Freedom Monday became sweeter for the fully vaccinated.
Freedom Monday, folks. Even the fact that you have an entire media apparatus, all these journalists, all these media teams, all these people, all these people who are pulling off this entire operation, walk down your street. Tell me how many people you see walking their dogs with masks on. How many people are driving their cars with masks on. It is just so bad. And I keep coming back to the fact, people say, oh, we'll say, Dave, that's so harsh. How could you be so harsh to say that Australia is rotten to the core? Don't you love your country? Well, we still live in a country where we are upholding, our authorities are all upholding a 90-year pedophile suppression order. So how can you tell me this country is not rotten to the fucking core? Why is not every single businessman, every single person with a voice, every single politician, every single police officer, every single person with a platform in this country, the fucking country should be on strike. Every man, woman and child should refuse to participate in anything until this fucking list of these 28 child predators who occupied the highest positions in this country is released. Nothing should, there should not be another thing happen. Reveal the names. So people are going to say, sorry, Dave, you've lost me. You're too harsh. Well, fine. You can't handle the fucking truth that this country is rotten to the fucking core. People don't give a fuck. They don't care. They just don't fucking care. I know you guys do. I know. And I'm generalizing. But there can be no such thing as a proud Australian until, first of all, we take care of the fucking elephant in the room, that the most powerful people in this country are part of a pedophile network. And everyone's just pretending it's business as usual. And all these mindless zombies roaming the streets, afraid of the invisible boogeyman who couldn't give two fucks about what happened to the children. They couldn't. They just don't know, or they don't care, or they don't want to know. Or all of the above. And so that's just where we're at, you know. And I said this on my Telegram channel. I shared something last night. Judgment's coming to Australia. A lot of people don't want to hear that. They still want to think it's all going to work out and we're going to win and there's going to be an uprising. I'm not sorry, folks. I think wrath is coming to this country. And so buckle in. Let's have a listen to the rest of this report.
You can have 10 visitors at your home. It was going to be 5. The cap on outdoor gatherings lifted from 20 to 30. 100 people can now attend weddings and funerals, up from 50. Indoor pools will reopen and swimming lessons are back on.
We know how important it is for families, for young kids to learn how to swim, but also for people who are injured and need rehabilitation.
All school students will go back to the classroom by October 25. And when we hit 80%, masks will no longer be required in office buildings.
These changes today, I think, will make a real difference. We want New South Wales to open up as quickly as possible, as safely as possible.
But the AMA will...
Sorry, folks.
It's too fast
to board.
But the AMA...
I just want to have a look at this cat. This Dominic Perrottet.
Hey, warns.
Hold on, stay with me. Let's have a look at this cat here.
Buildings.
These changes today, I think, will make a real difference. If we want you...
Why do they all shake their head like this when they're talking? Gladys did the same thing as well. She'd shake her head in the negative when she was trying to talk in the positive. Sorry, folks. I'm not buying anything this fella's got to say. Where do they find these people? Crikey. Aaron's just saying there in the comments, 52,000 at the footy, right? 52,000 at the footy. How absurd. So let me press play on this again.
I want New South Wales to open up as quickly as possible, as safely as possible.
But the AMA warns it's too fast, too soon.
Just because we've got a new premier in the driver's seat, that's not a good enough reason to deviate from that course that was set.
How old is this guy? This guy looks like he hasn't even finished university yet. Look at this. He's still waiting to get a bit of bum fluff on his face. I don't think he's grown his first little hair on his chin yet. This is a child. This is a child. Who is this clown? This person is in charge of New South Wales. What's it, the Australian Medical Association? Is it the Australian, the national one? He's a teenager. Oh, look who we've got in the background here. Is that Hazard? Oh, what a creep. Oh, look who we've got here. Hello. Where do they get this cast of absolute goons? It is... It's just a comedy show, folks. And here's one. Here's one, and another one people aren't going to like. Let me tell you another one people aren't going to like. See all these goons. I'm sorry, but they are a reflection, a direct reflection of the Australian, of the collective Australian character. You know, you get what you got. You know what I mean? We attracted, manifested, created, projected these goons. Because it is what the collective of Australia actually looks like inside. And a lot of people don't want to hear that. They want to point the finger and say, oh, these horrible politicians, these ghastly creatures, these terrible politicians. No, they're a reflection of the collective character of the people of this country. And I wish I didn't have to say it, but I know many of you get it. I know many of you get it because you've seen it in your own lives. You've seen your neighbours, your shopkeepers, your bankers, the people you deal with turn on you and be happy, happy to participate in medical apartheid, medical discrimination, happy to give you daggers when you walk through the supermarket, daring to show your face, gaslighting, bullying, manipulating, coercion, just because you don't want to subject yourself to the mRNA experimental potion. They will turn on you. There is so much hatred and sickness in this society, so much corruption at the top, and so much stupidity throughout the rest of society here. I'm sorry, folks. There's just no way to sugarcoat it. It is the absolute... We've all realized it's not the country that we thought it was. And now the rest of the world is realizing too. They're going, what the hell is going on in Australia? I'll tell you what's going on. Australians lost their way. Became too soft, too selfish, and manifested goons like this as a reflection of themselves. Harsh words.
Dr. Chant missing today. It was left to the health minister to deliver the new 9 o'clock daily COVID update.
The numbers have gone down again today, and today I can
announce. Sorry, my internet's a bit slow.
587 positive cases. So we're heading in the right direction.
And this guy, oh, another black-eyed creature. They've all got black eyes, folks. Look at this. Sorry. What was that? Cheryl Maloney just tried to get the buttons pushed. These people, folks, they, and this is why I actually don't direct a lot of hate and anger at the politicians, because You get what you got. You get what you manifest, right? What you attract, what you bring into your world. And as a collective nation, this is what we get. I'm going to show you some other stuff that's going on, right? This is what we all need to prepare ourselves for those of us who are aware of the plan. They are unveiling or unrolling the new roadmap to Freedom Day for the double quacks and so on. This is what's going to happen. And my strong advice is to... best insulate yourself for the, what's the word I'm looking for? The upheaval, not the upheaval, the civil breakdown that's going to happen, right? Israel is up to their fourth booster, right? And what happens is, let's read the article here, folks, shall we? Look at all this needle propaganda everywhere you turn. Israel has updated the terms of its COVID green pass to allow only those who have received a vaccine booster dose or recently recuperated from the COVIDs to enter indoor venues. The new criteria means existing vaccination passports will become non-functioning for nearly 2 million people in the coming days. So all these people who thought, beep, beep, got the two jabs, got my freedom, it's all done, we're going back to normal, they're going to get such a harsh slap in the face when, because this is how it's coming, right? All this contact tracing business where you scan in, that's all obedience training for your vaccine passport, right? Because you're going to get to the shops, right? Proper mark of the beast shit. You're going to get to the shops, you're going to get to a business that you want to do business with, you're going to have to scan in to make sure you're up to date with your booster. You're going to get to the front door, it's going to go beep, beep, beep. Access denied. You can't get into Coles. You haven't had your seventh booster. You haven't had your seventh bloody shot of graphene oxide. Sorry. That's where it's headed, folks. That's what the... it's happening. This isn't conspiracy theory, right? These people just got access denied because Israel is the first country to make a booster shot a requirement for its digital vaccination passport to encourage booster vaccination among those yet to receive a third dose. Sorry, third dose. I stand corrected. I said fourth. Oh, Israel's Ministry of Health has raised the bar on what it considers full immunization. Look at that closely, right? This is what's going to happen to everyone. In other words, they're going to move the goalposts. Israel's Ministry of Health has raised the bar, or in other words, move the goalposts on what is considered full immunization. So absurd, folks. It is so absurd. What I'm trying to put together, right, is I'm trying to understand why they need so many shots. Okay, we know of the existence of graphene oxide, right? Maybe they have to put in the graphene oxide incrementally. Maybe they can't put it in all at once. They need to constantly put it in. I want to show you something, right, for those of you who are awake. I queued this up a little bit earlier. This is the film clip, too. You may have seen this, right? Billie Eilish, however you say her name. She put this song out, incidentally, look when it came out. September 5th, 2019. Now, when you see the start of the film clip, incidentally, the song is called All the Good Girls Go to Hell. Charming one. Currently now at 194 million views, right? So this is how the predictive programming and subconscious engineering is actually performed. But if we look at the clip, many of you will know the clip, but Billy is getting multiple injections. Check this out. Right, you see that? Let's go back. See if I can get it. Ready? Boom. She's getting multiple jabs. Right? Don't know if you guys can see that. Let me just turn the volume up a little bit. Oops. Of the graphene oxide. Okay? There she is. You guys see that? So think about this, folks. What is going on here? Comes out just before the COVIDs. Look how many jabs she's got to get for whatever is going on here. Because you guys know about the transhumanist agenda. All right, let me show you something else right real quick before we go into this clip. You would have seen... Sorry, you're looking at my head and the flash. You would have seen Greta on the cover of this Saturday edition of Guardian. Okay? One eye covered. The time is now. The black goo. Got the full one-eyed symbolism going on. Okay? Tell me that's not creepy shit. And we have this propaganda from Billie Eilish saying all the good girls go to hell. Now, for those of you who know, I guess, the biblical story, that Lucifer, the light bringer, right? Lucifer, the light bringer, is cast out of heaven for rebelling against God. And if you watch this clip, it completely reenacts Lucifer being cast out of heaven for rebelling against the Almighty God, right? So check it out. Start of the film clip, Billy gets the jabs. Watch what happens. She starts transforming into this creature. And this, my friends, is Lucifer's fall from heaven. We're going to just go back on that, right? So just watch this closely. This is fascinating, folks. Okay? Multiple injections. She starts to transform. She grows these wings, right? And this is a representation of heaven and Lucifer being cast out. Okay? Coming down to earth. Lucifer cast out of heaven into earth. And what does he, she, remember Lucifer or Baphomet is a hermaphrodite, lands in this black goo. You guys with me? Look at this creepy shit, folks. It's hard to see with the screen reflection, sorry. Now she just said what to me sounds like, I don't know the exact lyrics, Lucifer is lonely. Let me see if I can get the lighting here a little bit better, folks. Just move that over there. Oops. Sorry, it's a little bit hard to see. Let's watch the clip here. Okay, what's she covered in, right? She's covered in this black goo. And she is singing all the good girls go to hell, right? Okay, look at that. The black goo. And what did we see back here? The black goo. Right, we go to Lady Gaga. What's going on, folks? What is being told across these? Now, that's a very, how can I say, gender fluid looking face there, right? Is it a boy? Is it a girl? Even the name Billie Eilish, right? Billy, boy's name. Covered in black goo. This is where it starts to get interesting, folks. This is where it starts to get interesting from an Australian perspective, is we start to find out, many of you would have seen this as well, that the health minister, Hunt's family, have been involved in graphene and vaccines, right? We can just start down here. Then I found an article on an experiment done in none other than the University of California, which just so happens to include one Professor Robert Bob Hunt, who by pure coincidence is Australian Health Minister, Greg Hunt's brother, and who receives funding through a foundation called the Hunt Lab, as does his other brother, Professor John Hunt at the University of New South Wales. So this stuff's pretty deep, folks. It's pretty dark. It's pretty dark, folks. But nothing is hidden anymore. That is just the reality of the situation that we find ourselves in, right? How this is going to play out, I do not know. But this should be enough to wake up just about anyone that it's not business as usual and that there is a real theme running through this, right? Let me show you something else. Let me show you something else, right? Hold there for a second, folks. Oops, that's not the delete button. Where's my delete button gone? Bear with me 1 second, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, I'm going to open a new tab. Stick around, folks. This is interesting. I hope you... I know many of you are awake to this. I wish I could read more of the comments, actually. But check this out. This is starting to get a little bit creepy. So, hold the phone. You guys seeing a pattern here? You guys seeing a pattern? Right. You guys seeing a pattern here? Radical shit, folks. And then we find out that this superconductor, graphene oxide in the vaccines. This press conference may make sense now, given Andrew Triggy Forest mines graphene. All roads lead back to graphene. As we already know, graphene is a superconductor. Superconductor. So, what is about to be conducted in the bodies of these people? You know what I'm saying? What is about to happen? What has actually been injected into everyone? You know what I'm saying, folks? It's actually, it's big stuff to wrap your head around. That's why I sort of sometimes go a little bit quiet, because once you start putting the pieces together, you can realize that something absolutely, absolutely sinister is on the horizon. Absolutely sinister is on the horizon. And, you know, it's like people, you know, I've got a bit of a platform over there on Telegram, and people, you know, they lobby me and they say, hey, Dave, you know, come and speak at this event, or come and promote this, or sign this petition or whatever. And I get it, but this agenda, this Antichrist agenda that is rolling out, I said this morning, the damage is done. The damage is already done, folks, right? I want to show you, you're not going to stop what is coming. You're just not going to stop it. It doesn't matter what you lobby or what you sign. And I understand you got to protect what you can do in the meantime. You've got to fight your battles in your local communities. And it doesn't mean that you just completely stop and surrender. It doesn't mean that at all. But it just means that there are certain events that are completely bigger than any of us can even imagine, right? And I want to just show you that theme. Hold there. I just want to show you that theme of, bear with me, folks. I've got some great stuff to show you if you want to stick around. You're going to see the same thing again, playing over and over and over. Many of you will be familiar with this song.
In life.
Oops, that's my head.
We hide the parts of ourselves we don't want the world to see. We lock them away. We tell them no. We banish them. But here...
Hold on. Before we watch this, let's just check out the viewing, right? This song has only been out a little while. 367 million views, right? Now, this is a guy, Little Nas. This is the guy who released the Nike shoes with the blood and the 666 and the pentagrams and the whole box and dice, right? He's a transgender. I think he's a transgender. I'm not too sure what he is. I can't keep up.
We don't. Welcome to Montero.
Right. I'm going to blow this up for you all.
I got it bad just today.
All this. Okay, so he's reenacting this sort of Garden of Eden kind of scene. He's under this bizarre tree. And then this creature shows up, right? Radical. Look at this. So I don't know if this is some sort of predictive programming for the fake alien invasion that is quite probably the next major event. Project Bluebeam, I don't know. But let's watch this. I want you guys to put some pieces together with me. Now, this is the other thing, right? You're going to see a lot of stuff in the New Age, which is promoting things like ancient aliens and all these ascended masters and the Galactic Federation and all these good guys who are out there. Not saying they're not out there, but there just might be a lot of bad guys who are disguising themselves as good guys, right? Because remember, Lucifer is the false light, it's the deception. Check out where this goes. So this is normal. a man of unknown sexual gender or definition is now pashing an alien with a third eye on his head, and this is normal. And we're the crazy ones. We're the crazy ones who just want to live our lives without being injected, maybe raise a family and have kids. We're the abnormal ones. This is just radical. Stay tuned, it gets better. Wow. Pretty sick shit. Watch this, right? You ready? So he's in chains there. He's some sort of prisoner, right? Watch this. Okay. Same theme. All right, if you guys have been on this call for a while, let's go back to, hold on, I'm going to bring this one over here. Stay with me, folks. We go back to Billie Eilish, right? What did we see? Check this out. She gets the shots. She turns into this devil creature, right? Look at this. Boom. There she is. Lucifer being cast out of heaven and down to earth. Then you get same theme, folks. Biblical shit playing out here, right? It's full on. Absolutely full on. And going down to signing a petition is not going to stop it, folks. There is just something so huge on our doorstep, you know. There is something so huge. And we're being told to hundreds of millions of people. And I'm just finding two examples here, folks, you know, of these common themes that are running through, right? We know that Greg Hunt here in Australia is involved with the graphene oxide. And we know that pop culture is warning us what is coming. And like I was showing earlier with our friend Mr. Hazard, and you'll see a lot of these people whose eyes don't seem quite right. And there seems to be something very, very wrong in their souls. So, makes you wonder, doesn't it, folks? Makes you wonder. Anyway, I won't go too much deeper into that. Probably given a few people a lot to think about. I know most of you are already well aware of this. But the agenda that pop culture is driving right now is so sinister and so deep. And if you've been with me from the start of the call, I was alluding to the fact that this whole great awakening is setting us up for yet another deception, right? This whole, how can I say, love and light movement, you're going to find that the light that they're promoting is actually the false light. Now, many of us, love him or hate him, you know, Alex Jones, right? He woke us up to a lot of different information through InfoWars, right? Now, this channel I'm following down here, if you're inclined and any of this is resonating with you, I encourage you, go and find E511 Ministries and have a listen to the stuff that these guys are, or this gentleman is exposing here on this channel. I'll play this little bit about Alex Jones here.
Mystery schools acceptable to people, Christians especially, and he strips out a lot of the explicitly occult and mystical stuff, but if you listen carefully and know what to look for, there are still just enough clues in his language that point to his quite obvious Gnostic allegiance. And
so where this guy's going, I'll just frame this for you. He's explaining that a lot of the people who claim to be exposing the New World Order are part of this agenda and very, very much involved with the occult and mysticism, like the upper echelons of Freemasonry. Have a listen to this. Alex Jones basically confessing that he is a Freemason.
And that make it clear that he's talking about the very same thing that New Agers like Kayla Ambrose are. He's just talking about it in a more watered-down way. So here's the first clip talking about his Masonic mystery school allegiance. A caller brings up his concern about finding out that Alex Jones is a Freemason, and Jones responds.
Listen, here's what happened yesterday. So I'm listening to your program. It's the middle of the day. I had a day off. I thought, you know what, I'm going to take a nap. Like anything, I thought, I've just started Googling your name, you know, because I enjoy your show, and I'm very intrigued with what you do, and I thought, well, I'll just get a little bit more information, and boom, out of nowhere, I read this article that says that you're a Freemason. Now, let me first of all say that I haven't met a Freemason that I haven't liked, but for years, I've had a concern.
You know, I have to probably say that I have major Masonic roots. I have never been part of a Masonic lodge. I've never taken Masonic oaths or rituals. A lot of my family, Texas was pretty much Masonic through and through, was Masonic, high-level Masonic. So it's the old-time religion. And all it is a university study of religions, of philosophy, and of building, and of mathematics, and of agrarian systems, because they didn't just bring anybody in to teach them the knowledge of warfare, the knowledge of science, the knowledge of culture. Universities were called mystery schools going back to Egypt, basically. And so what you see is...
Anyway, to get the full context of it, folks, you're going to have to watch that video, but I encourage you to go to this channel. His work is profound. E511 Ministries. I'll show you something else as well, which I really, really strongly recommend you have a look at. It'll rock you. It'll definitely rock everything that you think to be true. Bear with me. Remember that documentary that came out with Julie Mikovits? Okay. This one, Plandemic. I encourage you to watch that one. That will rock your world as to the larger agenda that is unfolding here. But guys, what I kind of see this all being about, right? My kind of take on this is that the graphene oxide and multiple doses of it is going to make people programmable, right? Might sound far-fetched, but remember that this whole agenda is to basically try and usurp God's power. And stuff goes deep, folks. I probably won't go too much deeper than that tonight, but all I can say is everything I'm learning about this so-called injection is something. It goes very, very deep and dark, folks. And a lot of people are already saying they know people who have had the jab, and they're not the same. They're not the same, folks. And that this whole idea, like, let me put it this way, right? If God, the creator, is the programmer, the ultimate programmer of reality, creates, he's the creator, right? And that this whole idea is to basically, this whole Antichrist agenda is to overthrow God. And then what if this stuff, once put inside people, makes them programmable? Instead of being programmed by God, they are programmed by the darkness that we are seeing come to earth. Right? There is no denying. Oops, hello, mate. He always makes my day. There is no denying this agenda, folks. And it's also no denying that it will require multiple injections, which is why you see the boosters, right? Anyway, folks, it's been quite the chat. Thanks for sticking around for a little while. Please get over on, wrong button. Get over on Telegram. We had a great day on Telegram today. I'll show you some of the stuff that we covered. Looks like Daniel Andrews could be about to go. I wonder why these people are stepping down. Is it because they're getting exposed, or is it because they've just done their job and it's time to move on? Either way, folks, we had a... Daniel Andrews got caught out here today. It was quite funny.
Like, seriously, you need to wear the mask. You will be pulled up. If I've got to change the rules again, sorry, we haven't changed mask rules. If I've got to go further, then of course we will. We're not going to have police being lied to. We're not going to have people just flouting these rules. Wearing a mask is about keeping you, your loved ones, and every Victorian safe. It is not too much to ask the nurse in the intensive care ward will be wearing a mask, and it's not too much to ask that you wear a mask in order to avoid that nurse having to treat more patients than they otherwise would.
Oh, folks, get on Telegram. Free speech is alive and well. Oh, this one was an absolute shocker.
Today, the call has gone out to everyone in home quarantine in Victoria to take part of our pilot program, and what that means is that they will receive random phone calls and they have to answer within 5 minutes with a selfie sent to this app, which will then geo-track where that person is and to make sure that they are who they say they are as well. If they don't answer within that 5 minute period, that's when health officers come knocking, Pete.
Sorry, folks, there's no coming back from this. This is the other thing that's coming as well, right? They've given a lot of teens Moderna, and now they're apparently getting sick. It is just, it's a lot to wrap your head around, folks. It really is. Here's the thing. Tomorrow's promised no one. There's no guarantees any of us will be here in 48, 24, 48 hours, right? You just keep living your life as best you can, folks. Be good to each other. Be good to each other. You know, I'm a big believer in getting right with the God of your own understanding, because we are in the craziest times. And if you're not careful, you could end up in ICU with the COVIDs like Osama. too funny. Anyway, folks, it's a bit of a different chat tonight, but I enjoy sharing some of that information with you, only because, you know, I guess it just reinforces the seriousness of the situation, not to take the injection, right? And just to keep doing everything that you can to try and warn the people around you. But there also comes a time where you've just got to step back. There's certain people that you're not going to wake them up. Maybe you're not supposed to wake them up. You know what I'm saying? You got to let some people be. Let them do their thing. You know, you got to let them do their thing. And you know, I just appreciate you guys having a listen. Appreciate you all being on the Telegram. Appreciate the support. I know a lot of you keep me in your prayers as well, which is really, 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 really beautiful. I appreciate that so much. We've had a few weird nights here in a row, actually. We've had, George and I have been having nightmares and sleep paralysis, and I know many of you have been having sleep paralysis and strange things going on as well. And not only do we have all this stuff happening in the physical world right now, we have all these different agendas, people trying to send us broke, people trying to inject us, people trying to track us, people trying to mock us and slander us and vilify us and all this sort of stuff. Not only have we got that here in the physical, but there's also the spiritual battle going on as well, right? There's also the energetic attacks that we've got to contend with, the psychological warfare. It's all happening. And so staying sane at the moment, if you're still here after 21 months of this horseshit, you're still here and you're still fighting, you should be really proud of yourself, because you just endured the most full-on psychological warfare operation campaign in the history of the world. So anyway, folks, God bless you all. Thanks for a great chat, and we'll do it all again soon. Bye for now, folks.